felt so real. It felt unnerving.
I could feel that you were ready to put this down.
Yes.
You know?
Bachelor number three, what are girls for?
I'm Anna Kendrick. I play Sheryl and directed Woman of the Hour.
I'm Daniel Zovatto and I played Rodney Alcala.
And we're gonna take a look at a pivotal dating game scene from the film Shot by Shot.
Bachelor number one, this is nice and easy. What are girls for?
This is a taping of the dating game. At this point, my character, Sheryl, felt very uncomfortable and has decided to write her own questions.
What do you mean?
Just what I said.
These guys were great.
I know. Yeah. The two bachelors were so fun to cut because they're roommates,
yeah.
Which I didn't know.
Yeah.
They both just like auditioned over Zoom. They were local. It wasn't until I hired both of them and they showed up that they were like, yeah, we're
best buddies.
We're best buddies. Yeah.
Gloria Steinem would be proud.
Being a little hard on the boys, aren't you, Sheryl?
Oh, I think we're all having fun.
Of course we are.
Aren't we having fun?
One thing I liked about it was that we had a live audience. You know, it just felt like a show.
It was the longest sequence that we shot, and we shot it like a play. It was like 25 pages, and we would do these 25-minute takes.
Why does this feel like a trap?
I don't know. Why does it?
Well, because if I say girls are for wining and dining, then I sound like a jerk.
I wanted the entire sequence, but definitely this scene, to be almost too colorful, too saturated, too bright. This particular frame, we were actually shooting on vintage cameras. We wanted that Technicolor feeling. They duct taped a flashlight over our shots. There would just be like too many lens flares, too much color. This almost parody of the idea of falling in love.
What are girls for?
Yeah, that's right.
This line was in the script when I got it, and it's so genius because it's so much fun to watch these boys just flounder.
Girls are for guys.
If I say they're for respecting or whatever, then I just sound like a schmuck looking to get laid.
And then Rodney gives an answer that is good, but it's not like earth shattering.
I guess I'd have to say that that's up to the girl.
The entire audience is just so delighted and charmed by him. There's this like cloying boyish quality that is so disarming and so confusing, because any suggestion that, well, if I met that guy, I would know. Danny bringing so much warmth and innocence, and it sort of shows how good he is at manipulating
exactly.
the audience.
Exactly, you know, I think that's one of the good, I mean, the qualities of Rodney is that he's able to kind of read the room.
You're really listening for what it is that this woman wants to hear and how to charm her and how to get her on your side.
Yeah.
Watch Woman of the Hour only on Netflix.